But the people had a direct affiliation with the power, and they made all the decisions. Also, the judicial system was also dependent on the people, and it was formulated in ancient Greece for the first time in history. Jurors were from 500 to 1,500, depending on the gravity of the crime. This way, they maintain the objectivity, and they ensure the anonymity before a decision had to be made. And a lot of people did not probably know that, you know, the word exercise, you know, the movie. But a lot of people don't know that the word ostrako, sea shell, was related to taking a person out of the community if he did not display good citizenship. So a person could be sent away from Athens, per se, not for a crime, but not for volunteering, not for not contributing, which is an amazing phenomenon, and it would be very well applied nowadays. And we know also that I have to make a reference to my wife, Presbytera Krissi, who's coming from the beautiful island of Kos. I call her my right and left hand, especially if that hand is squeaking, because I have no idea how to do that. And Presbytera Krissi and I would have a little bit of a competition. Whose island is better, Naxos or Kos? So today I will say about the scientific approach to medicine made by Hippocrates, the father of medicine. And that first hospital in Kos that you see in the picture, the first hospital in the history of the world. You have to understand, there was a time when most cities did not have running water, did not have anything resembling public services, and there was a hospital in a little island. The third one, the amazing playwrights, the theater. We're Greek, we know all about drama, we love drama. We also love comedy, and we love tragedy. Look at the Greek economy, and you know all these things collaborate, the comedy, and the tragedy, and the drama. But we also know that art is to be remembered, and Aeschylus, and of course Euripides, Sophocles, Aristophanes exemplify that art of theater way before Hollywood and all the other theatrical presentations. Also, I will say Aristophanes was my favorite. A lot of the jokes I was hearing from Seinfeld, actually they were originating from Aristophanes. And some of the word plays that I love, the longest word in the Guinness Book of Records is written by Aristophanes. When somebody walked up to him, to the actor, and asked him, "So what did you have to eat today?" This word is about 185 characters, and that was the food that he had. It was a combination of many ingredients. And imagine us standing there for 5 minutes and listening to the answer, "What did you have for food today?" It was an amazing, amazing, I know the second longest word, I learned it by heart. Kiminopistokardamoglyphos. So, try that. Another amazing thing, philosophy, mathematics, and geometry. Euclid, Pythagoras, you know, the Pythagorean theorem, Thales, the Milesian, Eratosthenes, who actually calculated the circumference of the planet using a stick. Not a satellite, not a rocket, a simple stick. And the shadow of the sun in an area south of Egypt. And he found the exact circumference of the planet. Now, these were amazing mathematicians. They developed machines that it would take centuries to be developed. Like the machine of Antikythera, he resembled by one of the universities in the United States that reproduced that machine that was the first GPS system, because we know Greeks, we get lost easily. My mom used to say to my dad, let's go somewhere to visit a relative or a friend, and then it's too early. Half an hour to find parking, half an hour to get lost, and half an hour to get there. Let's get now. So that was the first GPS machine, reproducing the motion of the stars. They created outstanding literature, poetry, mythology, like Homer's amazing poetry, or the love poetry of Sappho. They also spoke about monotheism. Don't forget about Pnika, the one God. Or Alexander the Great went to the Temple of Solomon, protected the Israelites from all invaders. And actually, in Israel, all the children born in the year when Alexander the Great came to Jerusalem were named after him. And to this day, you have a lot of people bearing the name Alex because of him, or Skinner. Now, the history books, we love history. Herodotus, Plutarch, don't forget about the amazing, amazing works that we have that now become movies, thanks to them. They studied and classified different kinds of plants and animals. They made amazing homes. That's the Palace of Knossos, very close to where Mr. Nikolaidis' house in Crete is, and looks like his house in Crete, actually. And this is where Nick sits. No, that was the king of the Cretan civilization, the Minoan civilization. But look at how amazing, and the colors. This is now from 5,000 years ago. And these amazing works of art, mosaics, it's fantastic, it's phenomenal to know that this was created in a time when really there was a scarce civilization on the planet. Of course, the amazing colossus of Rhodes, the buildings, the structures that we still have today, the Olympics that we still honor today, and that we have the amazing Olympic athletes, the words of the vocabulary that we use frequently, and in science, and all kinds of lexicons and dictionaries. We do have a lot of words. Kimono is not one of them, but the others pretty much have a good sense they are. And the military advancements. To this day, I have friends who are in the West Point Academy, and they tell me that they use and employ the tactics of Salamis, the naval, amazing naval, strategy of Salamis, or Thermopylae, the hot gauge, or Marathon, and they still teach them to this day. Or even the Phallus of Alexander the Great, they teach them to this day in all the military academies around the planet. It's amazing. And this nation, the forefathers of this nation, had a great admiration for Greek and Latin cultures. They proposed to teach in school Greek and Latin. They used to say, your mother teaches you English, come to school to learn the ancients. It was a very advanced idea at the time, but a lot of universities still employ it. They taught Greek history to inspire courage, and that's why to this day we have the exemplary paradigm of Leonidas still teaching the special forces of this great nation. Leonidas of the 300 is a story that they teach to the special forces, because there are times in life that numbers don't count, but heart. And when you have a heart, then you can overtake any adversity. And we all love that word. This is Sparta. This is a great, great thing that we can say whenever we feel overwhelmed in life. Also, the political system, the Athenian democracy, that inspired John Locke, that inspired through the works of Aristotle and Plato, the forefathers of a great nation, and recognized the need to be inheritors of the ancient philosophers. The most recognizable American emblematic monuments are replete with reference to ancient Greek architecture and beauty. All wars of Greece in modern history, and all wars of America in modern history, we have fought side by side. We're probably the only two nations that have managed this great accomplishment, to be brothers in arms in every single military conflict. I would I was impressed to do this research and find out that the first Greeks that came to the United States, Don Theodoro, came to Florida in 1528, died during his expedition, and Juan de Fuca, or Yanis Focas, who sailed up the Pacific coast and was looking for the fabled Northwest Passage, thinking that he will find a way to the Pacific from the Atlantic, from the north, and eventually became the well-known Strait of Juan de Fuca in the Canadian-United States border. And the 500 Greeks that came to the New Smyrna colony and settled in St. Augustine, and we see the beautiful chapel of St. Augustine, the oldest Orthodox religious name in this land, which is maintained to this day thanks to the generosity of people of the faith who come and help and make this a great place of pilgrimage. And those 500 initial colonists that came, and then among the first colonists, some came just to fight on the side of America. June 28, 1778, the Battle of Monmouth, New Jersey, great volunteers enlisted to support and achieve great victory for the independence of this great American nation. The town of Ypsilanti in Michigan received her name from Demetrios Ypsilantis, who sent his best, the best of the best of the revolutionary Greek army to fight and help liberate America. This is an amazing and spectacular act of heroism. The same happened when Greece started its revolution against the Ottoman Empire in 1821, as Mr. Anthony Santino referred to the day of March 25th. America sent warships and sailors. Some of them stayed to fight on the side of Greece. And Petros Mavromichalis, on behalf of the Messenian Congress, addressed Quincy Adams. And in many American newspapers, his plea was published. And Edward Everett, a Harvard professor at the time, he asked, let's help the Greeks find their independence. James Monroe, in 1822, said, a strong hope is entertained that the Greeks will recover their independence and assume their equal stature among the nations of the earth. And then, December 8, 1823, Congressman Daniel Webster from Massachusetts made a motion in Congress for the appropriation of money to send an American envoy to Greece for the support of the Greek Revolution. The first volunteer to come to Greece and fight on the side of the revolutionaries was George Jarvis, a New Yorker. What a great honor, one of our own, a New Yorker who went to Greece in 1822, a year after the fight began. He learned the Greek language. He put on the fustanella. Let me see, Alex, come and stand in the center. That's how he was dressed, so that he would be recognized as one of the Greeks. And they came to give him a name. Capitan Zervos. Jarvis Zervos. So he was baptized Greek. And he was brave, participated in many battles. He was repeatedly wounded. And he would not go back to America. He continued fighting, although he was wounded, until his death of natural causes in 1828. And he's one of the heroes of the Greek independence. Jarvis became a role model for others to follow, like Miller, Jonathan Miller, who is not nothing to do with Miller, who is in the Blake Patrick wedding. No, he is probably a far away relative. But Miller went from Vermont to Greece and adopted an orphan child who lost his parents at the war. Adopted little Lucas Miltiadis Miller, who graduated from Vermont University in 1845 and followed the example of these fine people here and became a civic leader, the first Greek-American civic leader who was elected state legislator in Oshkosh, Wisconsin in 1891. So this is an amazing story of the American dream. A little orphan child who became a leader in his nation. And also Samuel a Bostonian physician who fought and opened hospitals, a hospital in Aegina, and a hospital for the blind in Corinth. And George Wilson of Providence, Rhode Island, who went to the naval battle in Naupactus. James Williams, who was the first African-American to fight on the side of Greece in Baltimore. And he was with his Greek brothers, next to them, fighting for an independence that he knew very well. He had to earn on both sides of the ocean, and a great example. And Eastwick Evans from New Hampshire, who left his wife and children. Can you imagine what time are you coming home, honey? He fought in the war for independence and came back, Captain John Allen, who was together with William Thompson Washington, a distant relative of President Washington, and many, many others. They sent ships. They sent help from New York alone. Three ships with over $30,000 worth of financial support. Philadelphia, Boston, even more from other cities. And thousands of Greeks were saved thanks to the generosity and the love of the Philhellenes in America. And lastly, don't forget the thousands of orphans who came to this country and they were rescued and they found loving homes during all these military conflicts. A lot of people came, established churches. The first Greeks came in New Orleans, Louisiana. Then, of course, the beautiful church that celebrated 53 years this year in Holy Trinity in New Orleans. The only church, the entire block, by the way, was flooded. That church, not a drop of water. The entire block was flooded. And I saw the satellite images in the flat, and that nothing happened to the church. I was talking to the priest, and he was in awe himself. And also the amazing people who came to find a new beginning after wars, after genocides, after oppression, after great adversities. And we had this beautiful edition today of the anthem by Maria Ellis. Again, Maria, give a big hand. Maria is the daughter of Tom and Cynthia Bryas, and a goddaughter of my daughters, and god-sister with my daughters. And Ellis Island, your artist name, was the welcoming gate for America to embrace all these people with a dream. And this great lady that you see that was photographed a century ago and came to this land and built the Greek American dream, I call it. Millionaires, amazing people who have done a phenomenal job in creating jobs, in giving others the right to have a better future, in also respect representing our community. In our midst we have Mr. Steve Valiotis, who is one of the most prominent entrepreneurs and a great success story of our Greek American people, and we welcome him. And an amazing people who every year organize the parade at Fifth Avenue that we're having this coming Sunday, the 26th of March, with the Evzons who are coming to our church on Monday the 27th, the St. Demetrios community. So all the single girls, I know they're lining up already. There's 34 of them, and they're all tall and good-looking, I hear. So they are going to talk to us about the traditional attire and our people who build these gorgeous churches, like our beautiful Church of St. Demetrius in Mary, that I'm honored and humbled and blessed to serve as the pastor for the last 15 years. And amazing people who spearheaded science, mathematics, like Konstantinos Karathedoris, the teacher of Albert Einstein, Georgios Papanikolaou, you know, the pop test, one of the greatest doctors, and, you know, politicians like Spiro Agnew, former vice president, you know, Michael Dukakis and Paul Tsongas, Also, they were respectively in different eras and different sides, trying to get the nomination for the highest rank of the political office in this great nation. George Stennett, CIA director, George Stephanopoulos, commentator and political analyst, Ryan Scribus, who is actually, as we speak with the Archbishop, having dinner and also receiving the delegation of our great community on the White House with our president on Friday. And little known fact, Ryan's, his name is Heracles, Hercules. His wife was recently baptized, received the name Eleni. A beautiful family. They go to church every Sunday. They attend Bible classes. Their kids come to all the things that you guys do, all the things, Sunday school, Greek school, and all the things that you, they have a similar ministry like the one we have for the children that suffer from leukemia. They do have a similar ministry there too, and the children are part of every single event. Beautiful family. And we have people in the arts, Jennifer Aniston. Nick didn't tell me that she was at his hotel in Crete, but this is Jennifer in Crete, so Nick, you kept it a secret. And that's a picture next to the Cretan. That was Jennifer with her Papunche Yaya, again in Crete. Also, we cannot laugh with this guy, Zach. We shortened his name. He used to be Belikanakopoulos. And just kidding. Hank Azaria. I just put some of the people you didn't know. Tina Fey, Olympia Dukakis, both in law, of course, received many awards. Telly Savalas, the coolest guy ever. Some bad boys. Billy Zane. And John Stamos, some people tell me that when I eat yogurt, I look like it. And of course, Rita Wilson and her boy, Tom Hanks. Tom Hanks, who is, you see him here at the Good Friday service, carrying the tomb of Christ, as we do every year in our church. Saying here, I realize how important and beautiful it is to have the opportunity to go to church and reflect on important questions that the Orthodox Christian faith asks you and the answers it offers. And the beautiful example that we need, you know, some people to give a good example, especially celebrities, because they don't always do that. So we need a good example from those people who can influence others. And our histories together for centuries have been landmarked with beauty, with heroism, with stories of courage, with stories of aspirations, with amazing examples of people who manifested their love and their amazing talents. The histories of America and Greece together are still being written. And they make together a phenomenal, phenomenal place to be part of. Thank you, and God bless America, and God bless the people.